We call this meeting the order of the Oskaloosa City Council. Today is Tuesday, January 16th, 2018. Would you join me in the invocation? Heavenly Father, as we assemble here tonight, we thank you for the blessing of the people in this room. We've all felt your call to be part of the future of Oskaloosa and acknowledge the need for your guidance. For the council members and staff here, we ask that you bless us. Give us quiet, considerate attitudes, well-thought-out deliberations, and ultimately decisions that are best for the long-term future of the city of Oskaloosa. We thank you for those in attendance here and watching on the broadcasts. We thank you for leaders of businesses and organizations who have the vision and commitment to help the city, the countless volunteers who are motivated to help, and for informed citizens who have given us the privilege of their trust and support. Tonight, we've assembled a group of people who are making a difference in the long-term future of Oskaloosa. So may the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
That's my dog.
Roll call, please.
One of them.
Here.
Wally.
Here.
Gates.
Here.
Burnett.
Here.
Calgary.
Here.
Jimenez.
Here.
Moore.
Here.
Okay, thank you. We're moving into the agenda. The first item is an opportunity for community comments. This item is reserved to receive comments from the community for concerns whether or not they're included on the current agenda. The community is encouraged to come and speak before the mayor and city council, asked to keep statements brief, time limited to no more than 3 minutes. Any questions are to be asked of the city staff, the council members, or the mayor prior to speaking to the full council, so that way concerns can be properly researched and perhaps even answered away from the meeting. Comments are to be directed to the mayor and city council only. Is there anyone who would like to speak at this time? Okay, seeing none, we'll move on. Next up is the consent agenda. These are items that are considered routine by the city council. These are enacted in one motion. Did want to draw the council's attention to item H, which is the appointment to the airport commission of Jack Dietz. Also, the appointment to the housing trust fund committee. We have Valen McReynolds being reappointed. And then item L is just a resolution scheduling a public hearing for February 20th, to consider levying a special assessment against a couple of private properties for weed cutting. Do we have a motion of support for the consent agenda?
Move.
So moved.
Second.
All right. Okay, any discussion? Roll call, please.
Wally?
Yes.
Gates?
Yes.
Burnett?
Yes.
Calgary?
Yes.
Jimenez?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
Otteson?
Yes.
Okay, that passes. Moving into the regular agenda. First up is a request from the Mahaska Community Recreation Foundation to present their annual report. Sherry Babra, floor is yours.
Thank you. I love the floor. Did everybody get one of these in your packet?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. That's mine.
So this is basically an update for the year. This is our annual initiative. So we actually use Wildflower Trail has also been in another section over by Lysing, between Lysing and Penn, and the trail was complete this last year, and this coming year we will plant wildflowers there, so there'll be a nice new wildflower patch that you can go out to see. Okay, to open it up, there's our finances. That's just, it shows the annual income and expenditures. We do spend quite a bit if we have projects going on. There were some projects here, so you can look at the dollar amount there on the bottom. But we depend on donations and from you guys, we get the hotel motel tax. So thank you very much. You can look across there. The hotel motel tax, pretty consistent. If you look at the bottom, it gives you a bigger picture. We give you more years. So you can see, so that's our graph on, you know, what that consists of. Well, at least an average difference to the recreation. The next page is donations, and we do list, we have all the donations. We have a lot of and then we also have in-kind donations that have been all through the year, and volunteers are involved. So you can see we had a total of almost 9,000 hours of volunteers giving to Zero. This is still on the inside, but I'll put the second page. We had about 9,000 hours given to us last year, so I appreciate everyone. And then on the very back, it shows trail tram tours. That's the little extended golf course that we have that we do trail tours in the bay. We get a lot of nursing homes and people that can't walk on the trail, and we get a lot of carts. So the interesting thing this year is we had 21 people that came over 1,500 miles. Now, that's usually family members, you know, but it's just kind of cool to be different from where everybody is. The largest part comes from the community that we did the trail tram program for the community, but it's kind of cool that we're getting other people that are coming in and seeing homes. And then the dispatch at Lacey. We did have games and practices over 3,000 last year. If you look at the little footnote, I think it's interesting to note, 10 years ago, we had 640 games out there in 2007, and now we have 1,129 games out there this year. So, I mean, it's definitely went up. Part of that is because we built Babe Ruth Field, but a lot of that is because we bring tournaments in now that we never moved before. And they bring a lot of games and a lot of people down. So it's growing. I mean, it's consistently growing. So, any questions?
I have a couple. -$43,000. -$43,000 in the year. I mean, I'm looking at your any balance, and you had 97,000 in 14, 40, 24, 121,000. This year it says that -43.
You're right. And that was false. I did call and correct that, but they didn't reprint the total at the bottom. If you look at the top savings to checking, we added the 83,000. That was a grant that had been put over into the savings account, saved for that trail when we got, and so we had to spend it from that year before. So the 83,000 added to it made that 877,000.
So you're up about 40 grand then. So.
Yes.
Okay, cool. All right. And then the other question. MCRF, so educate me a little bit. So MCRF, I've usually associated with the fields and stuff out there, the complex. And then you got the trail.
Correct.
It says Mahaska Community. So does it cover, like, I mean, does it have anything to do with Edmondson Park or anything like that? I just didn't know what the vision was, I guess. So.
The entities that we own and that we try to do is the complex and the trail and the urban park downtown. So that's your state park and basketball.
Yep.
But it extends outside into the county and any little brother is with all the sports that come. So we have like Mahaska County Little League and City Little League.
Okay.
We have, you know, different county programs.
All right.
And we have college, of course, the colleges out there in high school. So.
But facilities-wise, it's the trail, the skate park, and the facility out at Lacey.
Correct.
Gotcha. Okay.
We could add some. We could always be...
Well, I didn't know. I just asked him, so. Okay.
Right now, that's okay. Anything else? All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Sherry.
Item B. So consider a resolution authorizing the advancement of costs for new streetlight poles on South 5th Street and 2nd Avenue East. This is part of the formal process to authorize an internal loan for installing 3 streetlight poles on South 1st Street and 2nd Avenue East using fund balances in the general fund. Approval of the item is part of the process to receive reimbursement from the tax increment revenue at a future date. So the scope of the work involves installing 3 new streetlight poles, which includes 2 decorative light poles on South 1st Street, and they'd be located between 1st Avenue East and 2nd Avenue East, and the addition of 1 new light pole on 2nd Avenue East between South Market and South 1st. So that continues the existing downtown streetscape improvements, Project has an estimated cost of $37,000 and an estimated completion date of June 4th, 2018. So in this instance, the costs associated with installing these new streetlight poles on South First Street and Second Avenue East are eligible for reimbursement under urban renewal tax increment revenue as it is included as a project in the adopted urban renewal plan. The process of advancing the funds from the general fund is being used because a debt over expense must be incurred prior to seeking a tax increment financing, asking, or reimbursement, and therefore must be cash flowed from a fund that is has a readily available balance. These funds are used, will be used for the costs associated with installation of the new streetlight poles. So staff is recommending the City Council approve the resolution. We have a motion supporting that.
Second.
Okay, discussion?
I think this is the case, but they'd be the similar decorative poles like we have around the rest of the downtown.
Exactly.
Okay. Okay. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Gates.
Yes.
Burnett.
Yes.
Caligari.
Yeah.
Jimenez.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Odison.
Yes.
Walling.
Yes.
Okay, that passes. Item C, this is to consider a resolution awarding a contract for installing the new streetlight poles on South First and South and Second Avenue East. So we've got the two decorative poles on South First between First Avenue East and Second Avenue East, and then one decorative light on Second Avenue East between South Market and South First Street. Musco Sports Lighting has provided a quote in the amount of $33,500 to install the streetlight poles. And if the project's approved by council, then Musco will be required to install all streetlights by June 4th of 2018. And if the council awards the construction contract, staff is recommending authorizing the city manager an additional $3,500 as construction contingency for unforeseen circumstances, and to authorize the mayor to execute all the related contracts.
I tried to ask Mike.
So we have a motion supporting that.
Second.
Discussion.
I guess first question for you, David. I'm traveling the last day and a half, so I didn't get a chance to get with you, but with me being an officer at Musco, should I abstain in this vote?
I don't believe so in these times.
So it's fine that I vote?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Any further discussion, questions?
Well, a question. Before we've done this, it's been spelled out that this was a good purchase. Is it still the same thing like we've done in the past?
Can you clarify what a good purchase means?
There's no talk about another bid.
We've essentially spec'd out the light right in previous years.
Right.
And so
they got a match.
Yep.
Yeah.
And so I trust that Musco, based on Keelish is the one who's run the project, but I trust that Musco has provided us the best price that they can.
I do too.
But and it's been consistent with the previous pricing.
I'm just asking. Yeah.
I don't have any concerns about it.
Okay, thank you.
Other comments or questions? Roll call, please.
Burnett.
Yes.
Caligari.
Yeah.
Jimenez.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Odison.
Yes.
Walling.
Yes.
Gates.
Yes.
Okay, that passes. Item D, this is to consider a resolution for preliminary approval of plan specs, form of contract, estimated cost, ordering publication of notice of hearing, notice to bidders, setting the date for a public hearing, and authorizing to receive and open bids for the Lacey Recreational Complex Roadway Improvement Project. So the City Council at the meeting on September 5th of 2017 approved a contract with Garden and Associates to design the Lacey Recreational Complex Roadway Improvement Project. Garden and Associates has prepared the plans and specs for the project, and this item will allow staff to proceed with scheduling the public hearing on the plans and specs. Also set a bid letting date for the project. So the scope of work, construction of approximately 2,950 feet of new pavement and rec trail and stormwater improvements within the Lacey Recreational Complex. These pavement construction projects are located west of the elementary school, presently referred to as Kentfield Drive by the folks at MCRF, and on 238th Street, west of North Green Street. The engineering cost estimate of the construction, $1,371,290. If the project's awarded, construction will begin on or about April 15th of 2018, weather permitting. The allowable work completion time for this project is 90 working days. Bids to be received and opened on Wednesday, February 7th, 2018, at 10 o'clock a.m., and presented to the City Council for a public hearing on Monday, March 5th of 2018. Staff is recommending approval of the item as presented. Do we have a motion supporting that?
So moved.
Second.
Okay, any discussion? A lot of detail here.
I don't know that it can be helped, but those are probably at least for the one road, some of the busiest times of use of that complex, but that's probably the cost of progress, I guess. April, May, June is when Little League season's in full swing, so we'll have to deal with that for 1 year, but it'll still be worth it when it's done.
Other thoughts or comments on this project?
It would have to be another temporary road. I mean, you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, a little gravel and bulldozer.
I'm going to go make one.
We'll have to work on detour signage.
Yeah.
It'll work.
It'll be just fine.
Progress.
Well, construction season is sports season as well, right?
Yeah. Yes, it is. Okay. Roll call, please.
Calgary.
Yep.
Jeanette?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
Osler?
Yes.
Wallach?
Yes.
Gayton?
Yes.
Burnett?
Yes.
Okay, that passes. Item E, considering a resolution for preliminary approval of plan specifications, form of contract, estimated cost, ordering publication of notice of hearing, notice to bidders, setting the date for a public hearing, and authorizing to receive and open bids for the Phase 1 Sanitary Sewer System Improvements Project. Garden and Associates prepared plans and specs for the Phase 1 Sanitary Sewer System Improvements Project. Item will allow staff to proceed with the scheduling of a public hearing on the plans and specifications and set a bid letting date for the project. The project is the first phase of the plan of action submitted to the Iowa Department of Natural Resources in February of 2015, as a result of notice of violation that was dated September 29th, 2014 from the DNR for bypassing raw wastewater from portions of the collection system and at the wastewater treatment plants. The scope of work for this project is a combination of multiple sewer projects. It includes the reconstruction of a sanitary sewer gravity main pipe east of 17th Street between A Avenue and 6th Avenue, the rehabilitation of sanitary sewer gravity main pipes and manholes in various locations in the northeast and southeast quadrants of the city of Oskaloosa. It's all mapped out. The project includes sewer pipe reconstruction, about 1,960 linear feet, sewer pipe lining, about 6,800 linear feet, manhole reconstruction, 15 of them, manhole rehabilitations, there's approximately 275 linear feet of that, and manhole invert repairs of 17 manholes. The preliminary engineering cost estimate for this project, $1,033,915.50. If the project is awarded, construction will begin on or about March 5th of 2018, weather permitting. Now, the project has a total of 110 allotted working days. Bids will be received and opened on Thursday, February 8th, 2018 at 11 o'clock a.m. and presented to the City Council for public hearing on Tuesday, February 20th of 2018. Staff is recommending approval of this item as presented and the approval of the resolution scheduled for a public hearing on February 20th. But I did want to note in here that there's no financial impact associated with scheduling the public hearing. Minimal charges there, but the project is budgeted in fiscal 2018, $1,240,000, fiscal 19, $3,780,000, and fiscal 2020, $2,060,000. So this is a bit of a march that we're going on in order to handle a number of the things that people are wondering what they're paying for with sewer rate increases. Do we have a motion supporting this resolution?
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion?
It really is. Go ahead.
No,
I just, Keelish, have we ever done the sewer pipe lining since you've been here? Okay, did we do some this summer?
Yes.
Okay, and did that go well? I meant to watch that, and I really didn't. My summer was
too busy. I
don't
think anybody had any complaints.
Okay, good.
It has been some.
Well, we had one bid, we were going to have it, and then it was too much, is what I think, and then we didn't accept that bid.
Correct, yeah, that was Piper's.
Pipe project, we didn't do.
Okay, thank you.
I just want to say, to what the mayor said, I challenge folks, this discussion we've had and the angst we've had over the amount of money we're having to pay for this, if they want to go take a look, they can see the maps in here and go see what a little bit over $8 million pays for, or not $7 million, I guess, isn't it? So a little over $7,200,000, $20,000. So what your $7 million pays for, what we're having to pay for in our bills every month. So this is what it's, this is what we've been talking about. So nobody likes it. It's all going to get buried by dirt, but it's got to get done.
But you can flush.
Yes, you can.
Hopefully it goes somewhere.
There's a silver lining there in there, Tom. So. Yeah.
And all seriousness, if you get a chance to watch Eggs and Issues last Saturday, the mayor did a great job of going through this again in pretty good detail when he got asked, and it really covered it. I knew what he was talking about, but when he got done, I knew better what he was talking about. So.
Agreed.
Any other thoughts or comments on this? Roll call, please.
Jimenez?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
Madison?
Yes.
Wally?
Yes.
Gate?
Yes.
Burnett?
Yes.
Calendari?
Yes.
Okay, that passes. Yeah, speaking of water and rates, next up is an ordinance amending Oskaloosa Municipal Code, Chapter 13.08, Section 13.08.570A, which has to do with user charges for the purpose of providing the funding necessary and associated with the operation and maintenance of the city's wastewater treatment works. We're going into the second reading on this. So the Sanitary Sewer Fund, or Wastewater Department, is an essential service provided by the city. This service is an enterprise utility fund, and as such, the revenues generated through the rates have to be spent on operation of the utility. The average residential customer utilizes 4.54 units of sewer per month, and based upon the recommended increase, the average sewer customer can expect their monthly bill to be $8.30 per month higher than it is today. As noted in previous public meetings, the city's infrastructure, specifically the sanitary sewer system, has been expected to face critical failures and the need for expensive improvements due to age, deferred or minimal amounts of maintenance, mandates received from the Iowa Department of Natural Resources and the Environmental Protection Agency. So as a result, over the past 3 years, four calendar years, our organization has embarked upon multiple design studies and improvement projects for the sanitary sewer system. All of the required system work has come at a sharp cost to ratepayers in the form of significant rate increases year after year due to the compressed schedule to complete the work. The recommended increase associated with this item also sets rates at a point where the future $32+ million sewer plant upgrade can be paid for without additional rate increases, assuming that there's no growth or loss in utilization and revenues meet projections. Future adjustments to the rate should reflect needed offsets for operational expenses or inflation, and this still allows the fund to make loan payments for the new treatment plant that has to be operational within 10 years. Therefore, if operational costs increase 5%, the recommended rate increase that year would be 5%. If operational costs increase 2%, the rates would be expected to rise 2%. Our staff is recommending approval of the item as presented. We have a chart behind in the packet that shows what the rates have been over the past years and where they are expected to be in the coming couple of years. Do we have a motion of approval?
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion on that? Yeah, just a quiet groan.
Yeah. Not heard over here on the base rates.
Yeah.
That's about.
Okay.
Where's that?
Roll call, please.
Moore?
Yes.
Madison?
Yes.
Wally?
Yes.
Gates?
Yes.
Burnett?
Yes.
Calendari?
Yes.
Jimenez?
Yes.
Okay, that passes. That takes us to the end of the regular agenda. Now it's the opportunity for reports from city staff. City manager, anything?
Mayor, council, just a reminder that we are meeting next Monday at 1 o'clock for our budget study session, or I guess it's a regular meeting. Again, we will work through the presentation like we did last year, and for Councilmember Otteson, it'll be your first time through, but we'll try to get you some advance information.
Okay.
In our meetings, plural, we've gone over a number of those items. So I think you'll be fine to hit the ground running.
Okay.
I will be issuing a memo to all of you likely Thursday. That'll be when your packets are ready. I'll try to give you a few days to review the information. The memo, as it sits right now, it'll go through each fund like it did last year. It's about 9 pages long, and so that's what I have here, putting the final touches on it today. So it should be ready to go, and it highlights all the things that are in there, items of note, more of the capital projects. The operating, the operations itself, we're not seeing any significant changes. We're not necessarily making any cuts. We're not necessarily adding anything. So we're spending a lot of money on one-time expenditures, vehicles for the police department as an example. There are 3 vehicles budgeted next fiscal year, which is rare, but this document will note that. But it won't necessarily get into how many pencils we have within each department or how much we're spending on paper. In years past, you've delegated that responsibility to me and the department directors to manage, and I believe we've done a good job with that. So we don't necessarily spend the time on that type of minutia. So if you have different feelings or thoughts about that, let me know. One of the big components of the discussion will be Meadow Creek subdivision. That is not included within the budget next year, but I suspect there will be quite a bit of discussion and debate about that and what we can do. And as I've told some of you who stopped in, the capacity for us to manage another road project is going to be difficult. That doesn't mean that we can't take on design or do something like that, but to do another construction project, one, I don't recommend it from the finance side, but also just because we have, oh yeah, by the way, $7 million of projects going to happen for sewer. We are going to complete the essentially $1.7 million for Lacey. We have a $3 million project for South D. And so we are as full as we can get with projects. And so a few years down the road, I think we'll be cleared up. We won't have much money left. So we'll have a little bit more time to take a look at that. But it's not in there, so I just want to make sure everybody's aware of that. If you have any other items that you'd like to discuss or think should be brought up for discussion, if you could email me in advance, that would be helpful. It could be anything. It could be anything like, hey, why don't we include playground equipment within Penn Central Mall so we have something to do in the winter? That would be something that we could discuss. I already have it on the list. But it's something that I think we ought to discuss, and it's those types of things. So if you want to see something, bring it up. That would be the ideal time so that all 8 of you can discuss, debate the merits of it, and then we can see how it fits into what we have financially as far as means to do so. So that's all I have.
Okay. City clerk, say, office, anything?
Yes, sir.
Okay. City attorney, anything?
Nothing, thank you.
Okay. Steve?
I'm good, thank you.
Okay. Tom?
EMC, the Emergency Management Commission, is still meeting. We met again this week. It's getting to be a very large meeting. The peanut gallery is almost bigger than the commission, and the commission is very big because there's a member from each town in the Mahaska County. I think we're going to have a vote next meeting. They're pushing that to get to decide how we're going to fund the radios, and then we can start spending more time about what the radios will be. Pretty much the group, not all, is on the same page that this is a countywide initiative that needs done for the security of the whole county. So the whole county should chair. I mean, Oskaloosa is about half the county, but we got the other half. So, you know, and rural will have to share. So I think we're getting closer.
It's good news. Done?
Nothing tonight, sir.
Nothing, sir.
Diane?
Nope.
Joe? Okay. I only had one item, I guess, and that was a former city council member who came off of this board made a point of emailing me to say that he had personally hand-delivered to one other individual of the council member his agenda packet. And I guess I was just going to ask if there were any editorial comments or other changes to the agenda from what you would have expected when it finally got to you.
No, I just glad it was timely. I've asked him not to be late when he brings it.
So I have nothing else to add. Do we have a motion for adjournment?
So move.
Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
We're adjourned.
Thank you.